Welcome to my new video. In this video I'm going to show you how to compare two tables. It's about checking whether both data tables are exactly the same or not. In order for two data tables to be exactly the same, five requirements must be met. These are, the number of columns in both tables must be the same, for example here we have three columns in each table. The number of rows must be the same in both tables, for example here we have three rows in each table. The third requirement is that the names of the columns are identical. Then it must be checked whether the order of the columns is the same. If this is not the same, then this should be done. That means, we sort the columns in the second data table as they are sorted in the first data table. This will help us later when comparing the contents of the tables. Finally, we check whether the content of the two tables is the same. That means, the content of each line is checked. If these five requirements are met, both tables are the same. If only one requirement is not met, the tables are not identical. The whole thing is implemented with C#. Let's start with the code. First, we need two tables that we can compare. We have an Excel file that contains two sheets. There is a table in every sheet. We want to compare these tables. Each table has three columns and eight rows. First, we copy the path of the Excel file. Add a read range activity. Enter the path of the Excel file. Create a variable for the first table. Copy the activity and create a second variable for the second table. Change the name of the sheet. Add an Invoke Code activity. Change the programming language from VB.NET to C#. Create the following arguments. Now let's start with the code. First we check the number of columns in the two tables to see if this is the same. If so, then go ahead. If not, a business rule exception is thrown that the number of columns is not identical. Add 1 second sleep. After that, we check the number of rows. If both tables have the same number of rows, the process continues, otherwise, a business rule exception is thrown that the number of rows is not identical. Add another second sleep. It is now checked whether the names of all columns in the first table exist in the second table. If so, the column in the second table gets the same order as in the first table. Add another second sleep. Finally, it is checked whether the content of each row in the first table matches a row in the second table. If only one row is not found, the two tables are not identical. So the code is ready. Oops. We have a bug in the code. I forgot the semicolons on line 19 and line 44. Now the code is ready. I will run the code. As you can see, both tables are the same. We didn't get any exceptions here. To make the code get better, add a try-catch activity. Add an exception like this. If the exception is caught, the exception is thrown in the console. I'm going to delete the last two rows from the second table. Now I start the code again. As you can see, we have an exception that the two tables do not have the same number of rows. I will reinsert the deleted two rows. But I will change the content. I will run the code again. As you can see, the contents of both tables are not identical. I copied the first table and added to the second table. But I'll change the order of the rows. This means that the tables are identical in terms of content, only the order of the rows is not the same. I will run the code again. As you can see, both tables are the same. I'm going to change the column order now. The content is the same in both tables. I will run the code again. As you can see, both tables are the same. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel to see more videos.